In this short video, we're going to look at the connection between vectors and geometry. So to start off, we need to understand the connection between vectors and points. And they are connected through a special kind of vector called a position vector. So let's just start with the xy plane. We've got the point O, which is the origin, and the point P, which I chose to have -6, 2. Now, we can have a vector from point O to point P, we call that the vector OP. It will have components -6, 2. And so this gives us a geometric representation of a vector as an arrow. It has a head, which is actually its terminal point, the ending point, and it has a tail, where it starts, or the initial point. So a position vector is a vector with its tail fixed on the origin. So our vector OP is an example of a position vector. And notice that when we write down a position vector versus coordinates, the exact same numbers appear. When it's points, we call them coordinates. When it's a vector, we call them components. And when it's a point, we use regular parentheses. And when it's a vector, we use angle brackets. Let's choose another point Q, different from P. I chose the point 4, 7. We can also have a position vector for point Q. It's the vector OQ, and it has components 4, 7. So what about the vector from P to Q? Well, we can certainly go straight from P to Q. That is the yellow vector shown here. But there's another way that we could get from P to Q. We could take the long way, go from P to point O, and then to point Q. Well, going from P to O, that's the opposite of OP. That would be the vector PO, or minus OP. And then going from O to Q, of course, is the position vector OQ. So another way to go from point P to point Q would be go in the opposite direction of OP, and then in the same direction as OQ. Now generally, we write this as OQ minus OP, and that's just algebra. Minus OP plus OQ, that's the same as plus OQ minus OP. But the way that everybody remembers this is that the vector PQ, we think Q minus P. We know it's going to be components, but we just think coordinates. We think we're going to take the coordinates from point Q and subtract the coordinates from point P, and that'll give us the vector PQ. So all of this writing on the first and second lines, we skip that. We just go straight to Q minus P. And so I'll take from the first coordinates 4 minus a -6, and then 7 minus 2, and that'll give me the vector PQ having components 10, 5. Let's do another example using this idea. So we're given two points in 3-space, and it really doesn't matter whether the points are in 2-space, 3-space, or 17-space. The properties still hold. So I'd like to find the vector PQ. Well, again, we think of that as Q minus P. And so I'll take the position vector for Q, means just change the parentheses to angle brackets and subtract the position vector for P. Again, I take the coordinates, change the parentheses to angle brackets, and now I'm just going to subtract those two vectors. Now, using the same point Q, suppose that I have a vector RQ with components negative 3, 9, and 5. I'd like to find the coordinates of the point R. Well, RQ is still going to be Q minus R, and it's the R that's missing here. So let's just call the components of OR ABC, so the position vector for R. And so I'll take 9, negative 1, 0, subtract minus ABC. That'll equal my given vector, negative 3, 9, 5. So I'll set the corresponding components equal to each other. So from the first component, I get the equation negative 3 equals 9 minus A. And I'll go ahead and solve that to get A equals 12. I'll do the same for the second component. That is 9 equaling negative 1 minus B. And solve that to get B equals negative 10. And finally, for the third component, I have 5 equals 0 minus C, which means C equals negative 5. And the point R has coordinates 12, negative 10, negative 5. Well, I hope you found this video useful. And in our next video, we're going to learn how to add vectors graphically.